No, I'm on some George Lucas shit right now. Oh my god.
Bodybuilder?
Nah, fucking the guy who made Star Wars. Like the director of Star Wars. You're gonna have to edit out this audio because I'm saying some dumbass shit. Get it.
What's up, fam? December 31st, so first off, by the time this video is all edited and up, Happy New Year, sorry if it's late. So what better way to end the year than with a leg workout? Now, I really gotta get more consistent with legs and everything, just at least squatting once a week and doing legs once a week at least and everything. Like, I feel like it's always easier to be focused on upper day, especially for a male. Seriously. We all know it. We all absolutely know it. So whereas I want to get my shoulders and arms up and everything, I really got to focus on my legs too. So just, you know, in terms of power and explosiveness and just becoming a complete athlete, a hybrid athlete, not just a weightlifter and everything. But yeah, so we're going to hit some legs, probably gonna do some abs so the abs are activated and everything before you lift. That's something I've been keeping in mind that I want to do, is doing abs before every session, because no matter what lift you're doing, your core is engaged and it's ready to go, thus making that lift easier. So, gonna go inside and get all warmed up for legs. Let's do it. All right, so the gym is popping. New Year's Eve, everyone's here, so therefore all squat racks are taken. So, moving on to my next most important leg movement, stiff leg deadlifts. I'm working it with the 60s here. Now, what I did, because I haven't done this movement in quite a while, on my recent leg days, I haven't done it. Just like, I haven't been in check with my leg days. So, this used to be an important movement to me, because it really helped develop my hamstrings. So, I worked it with 30, 40, 50 to warm up, get the movement back, you know, get my body familiar with the movement again, and then I grab these straps again to hold down to the 60s, because when it comes to weights, my grip sucks ass. So we're going to do this for about 4 sets of 10. I already did one, do 3 more. Waking up, feeling the taste of a fight last night.
Thinking about old times.
season 2016 to Zeke. Just to recap 2016, I can't even begin to explain the changes I've been through, things that happened. This has been a really crucial year for me. I took the step, did the whole fitness thing, started off last December, so basically this whole year has been my first year in the fitness industry. I'm very happy I took that step because it's always the first step's the hardest. And I've enjoyed it the whole time. You know, creating content, creating a legacy, watching myself grow. And it's always something to look back at, which is pretty cool. I transferred to SUNY Cortland from community college. Went from working, being a commuter student, to living on campus, building lifelong relationships. And, you know, building my academic discipline, just studying so much, which I'm very happy for, having the opportunity to go study elsewhere. Before that, I just lived in Great Neck in this house my whole life. And I never thought I'd branch out over there. You know, I thought I want to go to Florida. Oh, it's warm, this and that. But I don't regret going upstate because I created lifelong relationships. And even while I'm home and I'm hanging out with these people, and it's a great feel, great feeling, you know, just building relationships. Also, some have ended, not an ideal way. Like, it was also a crazy year because I knew a bunch of people that passed away. May they rest in peace, including my grandfather. And it wasn't easy. It was also the hardest time in my life this semester. But I took it head on by the horns and have really grown from it. So, sorry, I keep looking away. It's just the way I'm thinking. But, you know, it made me learn you can't take anyone granted in your life, really. I'm sure I have. People who are watching probably know I have and, you know, been selfish or just, like, really focused on myself with the lack of balance. But, you know, you just gotta observe. The first step is acknowledging these things, and you just gotta observe it, and you gotta be determined to be better each and every day. So, that being said, you know, reflecting back in 2016, I could still say it's the best year of my life. Grew in a bunch of ways, and 2017 is only gonna be better. So, continue on. Forever growth, intrigue success. Happy New Year. Stay safe, people.